Have you ever wondered what happens to the air in your scuba tank as you dive deeper and deeper underwater? There's an invisible force at play, which is called Boyle's Law. And today, we're going to break it down so you never forget how pressure and volume are linked, and how understanding that link keeps you safe below the surface. Hey everybody, I'm Marissa. I'm a Paddy Master scuba diver, and I have a passion for diving, the ocean, and everything below the surface. On this channel, you'll find dive experiences, education, real discussions on mindfulness, personal growth, and ocean conservation. Whether you're a diver, an ocean lover, or someone looking just to breathe a little deeper, you've come to the right place. Now, let's dive in. What is Boyle's Law? Boyle's Law was created by Robert Boyle in 1662. He was an Irish natural philosopher, chemist, physicist, and inventor. Boyle's Law states that at a constant temperature, as the volume of a container decreases, the pressure within that container is going to increase. And it goes vice versa as well. So if the volume of a container increases, then the pressure is going to decrease. And this is what these pictures show you here. As the volume increases, then the pressure is going to decrease. And if the volume decreases, then the pressure is going to increase. Think of a syringe. If you have a syringe and you pull back on the syringe to draw in some air, you're creating space within the syringe, right? And if you put your finger on the end of it to close it off, and you push on the syringe, you're gonna decrease that volume, and that air is going to move into a smaller space, which is gonna increase the pressure. So it's the same amount of air molecules in a smaller space. And you can feel the resistance, which is the increase in pressure. As you move your finger, you're gonna hear it pop, because pressure is always gonna move from high to low. It's pressure equalization. So in regards to scuba diving, in your scuba diving tank, the air molecules at surface level will have a lot of area to move around in. And as you descend underwater and go deeper and deeper, the volume is gonna start decreasing because of the pressure. So that means that the pressure is gonna increase and the air molecules are gonna have less and less space to move around in. And there's other places where pressure affects areas, such as your ears, your lungs, your sinuses, and the mask that you're wearing. I also have an entire episode on equalization, and I'll put it in the description below for you. And these spaces have to be equalized or it can result in injury. And this is why it's extremely important in scuba diving to never hold your breath. Holding your breath can result in major lung injuries. There's lung squeezes as you're descending, which are rare, but they can happen. But as you're ascending, as you're coming up, you always want to continuously breathe, because as we know now, as you ascend and you come up to the surface, the pressure decreases. So if you have a decrease in pressure, then you're going to have an increase in volume. So your lungs are going to expand. So if you're holding your breath as you're coming up, your lungs are getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And if you don't breathe, you can have a lung overexpansion injury, and nobody wants that. So please don't hold your breath. But pressure and volume always play a tug of war underwater. And it's always important to remember that as you descend, it's going to influence the gas that's in your tank, which will then have an effect on you as you breathe it in. This gets into the specific pressures of the gases that are in your tank and how they affect your body. This will actually be next week's episode on Dalton's Law, where we talk about the partial pressure of each gas and the effects that it has on your body. If this video helped you out at all, please like, comment, and subscribe. You can even share it if you like, if you know someone who needs to get a refresher on this. And always hit the bell so you don't miss an episode. We'll see you next time, guys. Bye.